think governments are obliged to provide such tax incentives? Is it obvious that governments would be willing or would have an interest to provide such incentives? Because this is not so obvious. We normally jump to the next stage where we request the tax incentives, but sometimes we need to provide the rationale why we want these incentives. And very often, people, especially from civil society organizations, claim that tax incentives are important because in this way you support philanthropy and giving. And the truth is that tax benefits are not the biggest incentive for donors. So if I want to make a donation, the fact that there is a tax incentive for my donation would not be the prime motivator for me to donate. It would not be even the second reason why I donate, not even the third reason why I donate. So this is one very important thing we need to have in mind. Of course, the existence of tax benefits influences the decision and also influences the amount I would donate. But it's not the primary motivation for donations, and we should be clear about this. Then why would governments be interested in providing tax benefits? A research found out that actually the biggest benefit of having tax benefits and supporting donors would be the very fact that the existence of diverse civil society organizations is the biggest benefit of having such mechanisms to support philanthropy. And this is important. Another thing some people use is that more people give in countries with bigger tax incentives for donations. However, it is not so clear whether people give more because there are bigger tax incentives or because there are more donors in that respective country. They push the government to introduce bigger tax exemptions. So it's not clear what comes first, which is the chicken and which is the egg. There is correlation, but it's not clear which way. Okay, so once I started with this more theoretical thing, I have prepared a list of the possible tax benefits that governments usually provide to CSOs, and I'll go one by one. So the first one is, of course, tax exemption for companies or individuals, for the donors. There are two main types of tax exemptions: tax deductions and tax credits. In the case, tax credits are not so popular. Very few countries have tax credits. This means that when you make a donation, you deduct it from the amount of the tax you have to pay, which is tax credit. In the case of tax deduction, you take the donation out of the tax base. So you decrease the amount on which the tax is actually levied. And we can talk more about it in the discussion or if you have any questions, because maybe it's not that clear. So when we speak about tax deductions, we usually have in mind money. But it is not only about money. Another possible tax benefit is to be able to deduct in-kind donations. And there are various technicalities linked to in-kind donations, how you evaluate this, etc. The third type of exemption is exemption from other taxes. Usually it's traditional that the CSO that receives the donation, for that CSO, this income is tax exempt, so you don't pay income tax on the amount of the donations you receive. But it's not necessarily so in all of the countries. So this is one natural tax exemption for donations. Sometimes, for example, in Bulgaria, there is a local tax levied by the municipality, by the local authority where your city is, on donations. And some organizations are exempt from that additional tax, others are not. Then the fourth type, donation when you die, so inheritance. Many countries exempt inheritance to civil society organizations, but not necessarily. So this is yet another type of support for giving. The fifth type of exemption is VAT on donations. Usually there is no VAT on money. But if you organize a charitable sale of goods, for example, or a concert, where you sell the tickets and you use the money for a charitable purpose, would there be VAT on your income or not, and in which cases? Or I can give you the example, it's a very interesting example, again in Bulgaria. It turned out it is cheaper for food producing companies to throw food that they cannot use rather than donate it, because if they donated it, they had to pay 20% VAT on the amount of the food. You know, and until they introduced an exemption on this process, you know, people were throwing food just because, I mean, it was too expensive to donate it to the people that needed it. The next exemption is related to one of the methods Petra mentioned, charitable text messages or SMS. In many countries there is VAT on the charitable SMS that you send. And the reason is that tax authorities consider SMS as a service, and there is VAT on services. So until you try to redefine the charitable text messages as donations, it is very difficult not to pay VAT. And there are all sorts of complications in different cases. The VAT would depend on the fact whether you pay monthly fee to your mobile operator or you have bought a prepaid card in advance and then you send SMSs. Another related to philanthropy benefit is the possibility to give out of your payroll on a monthly or regular basis. And this is important. It's not an additional benefit, but it's a possibility that employees can use. And it's important because it eases the process of giving. Very often, and I'll speak about this in my next slide, very often, in order to use a tax benefit, you need to file a tax declaration. And in many countries, people that receive only income from a salary, they don't have to file tax declarations. You know, but if they want to use tax exemptions, by law, they are obliged to declare this donation they've made. Another possible benefit is if you donate a large amount of money this year, you can deduct it in the following years. And I'll show you an example. And finally, the percentage mechanism is considered by some as sort of philanthropy. And I'm not going to speak about what the percentage mechanism is right now. But this is not philanthropy in general. I just listed it here for purposes of to show it and compare it to the others. So, after I listed the benefits, it's important also the process of how you can use those benefits. Is this process simple? Do you need to submit tax declaration, as I said? Is there a limit on the gift you can make? In some countries there is a minimum gift, so if you donate below than a certain threshold, you cannot use tax benefits, or if you donate more than a threshold. Do you need to prove the donation? What documents do you show to prove that you've made the donation? Do you need a special registration or a status to be able to use it, and this is for organizations? Or do you need to work in specific areas only if you want to get a benefit? And I've listed here some questions that are important, because in many countries governments make some interesting decisions with regard to philanthropy. First of all, should you introduce the same benefits for all types of causes? So if you introduce tax benefits, should the benefit for giving to culture and giving to sports be the same? And in some countries, governments think they can introduce different benefits. Our opinion is that if you provide benefits, they should be flat rate for everybody or for all the causes that you introduce as beneficial. Is there a possibility to have regular donations? This is very important for organizations that want to build a loyal core of supporters, that each month or each 2 months provide you regularly with a donation. In some countries, because of the legal theory, it is not possible to make this, because the promise of the donation is not legal. I'm not sure how it is in Ukraine. Should the government provide tax benefits for donation to itself? If you, for example, should there be tax benefits for the private donations to state hospitals, let's say, and to government-established organizations, or only to civil society organizations that are independent from the government? This is also an important issue to discuss. Should you provide tax benefits for all areas or only for specific areas? It is normal that, for example, governments provide tax benefits for donations in the healthcare area, in the social area, in culture, but not so obvious if you provide donations for human rights or democracy, for example. And then there is also another question, because we very often use the terms interchangeably, donations and sponsorship. So what is the difference between these two and how they should be regulated differently? And this is my final slide. I just wanted to show you three examples of specific benefits which I think are interesting. In Hungary, there is the possibility to deduct up to 40%, to deduct donations up to 40% of your annual income, if this is for long-term donations, meaning if you agree that you will provide the same or bigger amount of donation in the following 3 years. The normal deduction is 20%.